Congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Next topic is congenital hyperplasia is a group of inherited disorder marked by congenital deficiency or absence one or more enzyme essential for the production of adrenal cortical. It is an inherited and autosomal recessive disorder. The enzyme involved most commonly 21 hydroxylase 92-95 deficiency of 11 beta hydroxylase and 5 to 8% and 3 beta hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase also lead to CAH, congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Congenital adrenal hyperplasia is a family autosomal recessive disorder of cortisol biosynthesis. Cortisol deficiency increases secretion of corticotropin ACTH, which in turn leads to adrenocortical hyperplasia in overproduction of intermediate metabolism. Depending on the enzymatic step that is a deficiency, there is may be signs, symptoms and laboratory findings to minor allocorticoid deficiency or excess. Incomplete variegation of premature puberty in affected males and variegation in sexual infantilism in affected females. Congenital adrenal hyperplasia due to 21 hydroxylase deficiency. More than 90% of CAH cases are caused by 21 hydroxylase deficiency. P415 enzymes, CYP21, P415, C21 hydroxylate progesterone and 17 hydro progesterone and 17 OHP to yield 11 deoxycortisterone and DOC and 11 deoxycortisone respectively. These conversions are required and synthesis of aldosterone and cortisol respectively. Both hormones are deficient in most severe salt wasting for the disease. Slightly less severe the affected patients with are able to synthesize adequate amounts of aldosterone but have elevated levels of androgens and adrenal origin that is termed of simple variegation disease. This true form of collectivity term classified 21 hydroxylase deficiency patients with non-classical disease have a relatively mildly elevated levels are androgenous and may be sign of androgenous excess postnatally. Classic 21 hydroxylase deficiency occurs about 15,000 to 20 worth the most population. Approximately 75 affected infants have the short losing of years, 25 have a simple variegation from a disorder. Non-classical disease a prevalence of about 1/1000 in general population but occurs more frequently specific ethnic groups of such as Ashkenazis, Jews. Clinical manifestation, aldosterone and cortisol deficiency, progressive weight loss, anorexia, vomiting, dehydration, weakness, hypotension, hypoglycemia, hyponatremia and hyperkalemia. These problems typically first develop in affected infants approximately 2 weeks of age. Treatment, shock, cardiac arrhythmias and death may be occur within days of week. Prenatal and adrenal excess. The most important problem caused by accumulation of steroid precursors in the 17 hydroprogesterone inserted into the pathway for androgen biosynthesis leading to high levels of androstenedione that are converted outside of adrenal gland to testosterone. This problem began affected fetus by 8 to 10 week of gestation leads to abnormal genital development in females. The external genital mass males to females normally appear atypically early gestation in normal females. The genital tubercle becomes clitoris, the urethral folds develop into the labia minora and labia scotus swelling become the labia majora. In males in development, the external genital is normally controlled by the testosterone secreted by fetal testes. The genital tubercle enlargement become glands and penis. The urethral folds of fuse to the form of shaft and penis, the penile urethra, and the labia scrotal swelling fuse of from the scrotum. Testosterone also controls the development the fallopian ducts to into the male internal genital structures such as the prostates, spermatic ducts and the epididymis, but higher levels of testosterone are required than for the development and male external genital. In contrast, testosterone has no effect on developmental female internal reproductive structures, cervix, uterus, fallopian tubes from the Miller ducts. In males with fetus that is a fallopian tubes, the Miller ducts, the male feature is the structure involved under the influence of the anti-Müllerian hormones, Müllerian inhibitory factors secreted by the testes. The respected females, how are exposed the utero high levels of androgens adrenal origin have muscularized external genital. This manifests by enlargement of the clitoris by the partial complete labial fusion. The vagina usually has a common opening with urethra. The clitoris may be so enlarged that a resemblance of penis become urethra opens below the organs. Some affected females may be mistakenly presumed to be males and hypospadiasis and cryptoperidism. The severity of irritation greatest in the females of salt using from the hydroxylase deficiency. The internal genital normal because affected females have a normal ovaries, not tested, does not secret anti-fluorine hormone. The perinatal exposure of the brain high levels androgen may be intolerant, influence frequent sexually diaphoretic behavior infected females, girls tend to insisted masculine toys such as cars, trunks often be so decreased interest in playing with dolls. Women may be decreased interested in maternal roles. There an increased frequency homosexuality in affected females, but most function heterosexually. It is a unusual affected females and assign themselves as male role. The male infant appears the birth, that is diagnosis may not be made by the, until the sign of adrenal insufficiency develop. Because patients with the condition can deteriorate quickly, infants boys are much likely die to girls. For this reason, many states and countries have instituted newborn screening for this condition. Postnatal androgen excess. Postnatal androgen excess. The sign of androgen excess will include rapid somatic growth, accelerated skeletal maturation. Thus, affected patients are in childhood but premature closure of epiphysis closure. Growth stopped relatively early. The adult stature of sustained muscular development may be excessive. Pubic and axillary hair of the appear, acne and deep voice of may develop. The penis, scrotum and prostate may be become enlarged, affected voice. However, that usually of polypluity size of relatively small in contrast is the enlargement penis. Occasionally ectopic adrenocortical cells in testes patients become hyperplastic similar to adrenal glands producing of testicular adrenal trash tumor. The clitoris becomes the further enlargement affected females. Although internal genital structures, the female breast, developmental and menstrual do not occur unless the excessive production of androgen is suspected by adequate treatment. Similar but milder sign of the androgen occur in non-classical 21 hydroxylase deficiency in this attenuated form. Cortisol, aldosterone levels are normal. Affected females have normal genital at birth. Males, the females may be presence of precious pubers and early development of pubic and axillary hair. Hirsutism, acne, menstrual disorder and infertility may be developed later life. However, many females and males are completely asymptomatic. Laboratory findings. Patients with salt losing disease of hypertypical laboratory findings associated with cortisol aldosterone deficiency, including hyponatremia, hyperkalemia, acidosis, often hypoglycemia. Body levels of 17 hydroxyprogesterones are markedly elevated after infancy once of circadian rhythm of cortisol established. 17 hydroxyprogesterones levels are very same circadian pattern, being highest in the morning and lowest at night. Blood level of corticals are usually low patients with the short losing or type disease. They are often normal of simple valiaging types of one inobservably low retention of ACTH and 17 hydroxyprogesterone levels. In addition, 17 hydroxyprogesterone levels of androgens and testosterone are elevated affected females. Testosterone is not elevated affected males because normal infants. Males they have high testosterone levels compared with the those seen later in childhood. Level of urine, 17 ketosteroids and pregnenolone are elevated but are rarely usually clinically because blood samples are easier obtained 24 urine collections. Cortisotropin ACTH levels are elevated, have a diagnostic guarantee over 17 hydroprogesterone levels. Plasma levels of renin are elevated. Serum aldosterone is inoculated low for the renin level. However, renin levels are normally high in the first phase of life. Diagnostic and treatment. Prenatal diagnostic 21 hydroxylase is possible late in first trimester of analysis DNA. Obtain chorionic villus symptom sampling or during the second trimester of amniocentesis. This is usually done because parents already have an infected child. Besides, genetic counseling to be main goal of perinatal diagnosis facility associated perinatal treatment affected females. Recommendations of pregnancy at risk consist admission dexamethasone stored up crosses the placenta, amount of 20. Question mark, usually a pregnancy material weight of daily in 2-3 devices doses. This suppresses secretion of stored adenyl including secretion adenyl adenosine. If started 6-week gestation of ameliorates the variation of the external genital and infected females. Chronic villus biopsy then performed to determine the sex genotype. The fetus therapy continued only of fetus affected male. Maternal side effect perinatal treatment have included edema, excessive weight loss, hypertension, glucose intolerance, and congenital facial features and severe stress. This topic is complete. Thank you, everyone.